Welcome to RPF. In this video, we'll discuss about how to add employee in any HRMS related application using Power Automate. Power Automate is one of the RPA based fine tool which we can use it for automating our manual stuff. So if you want to automate that process using Power Automate, then we can use Microsoft for Automate for quicker response. So let's run this flow and see how it works. Then probably we'll see how to create the flow from scratch. Now the execution has been started. If you can see, already HRMS system automation has started. The bot will enter username and password, and then it will close both the pop-up, and from PIM, this will start adding detail of an employee or creation of an employee. Now this employee code is already exists, that's why it's showing it's already exists, but we can change the employee ID accordingly. So this is how we can add employee in HRMS system automatically using Microsoft Power Automate. So we'll see in detail how we can create this flow from scratch. So let's delete all this flow so that we can build it from scratch. Now, first we have to launch the browser. For launching the browser, we can drag and drop launch new browser. So here, once we launch new browser, we have to specify the link. Once we'll enter this link, this whenever the automation will start, it will navigate to this link and open the browser. Next, we want to fill up the username and password. So for that, we will use populate text field in window. Here we will use add UI element. We already have this details are available here, which we can use it for our automation piece. So first we'll use this as select, and you can see the username we can enter as admin. If you want to use it in the different way, we can also use the additional text box. So if we don't have the text box available, we can select it from the screen. Let me show you orange. Now from here we can drag and drop, and from there we can populate the value. So add UI element, click on this and hit Control plus left click of mouse button. Now here we have to specify the password. So at the time of adding the password, we are just entering the detail, click on save, and now we have the username and password field is enter. Next we want click options. So for clicking on any UI element, we'll drag and drop UI automations, click UI elements in window. Now to click left click, we can just use already existing button. So we have existing button as login, which is already specified selected because we have created in last options. Next is post that once the login will be done, we want to see the PMI, mean 123 password, username and password is here. Now post that should click on this close tab. So for that we have to again use the same, and We have already used this. That's why these options are available. Now click on close. Select save. Next tab, again we'll need one options to select the button as never. Click on save, and post this options are done, we have to click on this PIM. So next options will be again click options. So just add it, click PIM. We have this options are available. PIM 2, 3. Select this. Done. Next, we want to click on add. Once we'll click on this, we will have this add button. So again, click UI element. Click on save. Next, we want to enter the detail of the employee. Once we'll click on this, it will showcase the first name, middle name, and last name. So here we want to use populate text field in window. So here we will use first name. This one, in this we want to add RPA. Click on save. Again we'll use the same fit because we have to enter the middle name. So middle name is also working middle name is here. So here we'll add hub, save. Again we'll use the same activity. Then last login and click on save demo. Done. Next, we want to enter the employee ID. So which is again required, populate the field text. Now we have to enter the employee ID. This field is not there, so probably we'll use it from the UI element, but this is not open. So here what I will do, we'll press control and left mouse key, then we can enter the value. So enter the value 0269. Click on save, and next post adding all this value, we have to click on save and click. Now done. After that we'll show the display message box. So we'll show display message box as in this field is created. So we'll show here the RPA. So show RPA demo is, even we can create the variable and we can use that variable to showcase here. So this is how we are building a flow which will automate our employee additions in HRMS system by using Microsoft Power Automate, which is very easy to perform it, and for manual thing this will take lots of time. But once this bot will be generated, we can use this bot forever for addition of new employee in HRMS system to save the HR team time or to save the admin team time. So that's all about this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.